So, I hear that the ultimate was thrown at me and Luke, Sin City Preacher. We have been called wolves. Beware of them. Beware of the wolves that are teaching you false doctrines and keeping you away from Christ. Yes, we're called wolves. Okay. First of all, I'd like to say that I do like to have lamb chops once in a while. Sometimes I wear a wool hat or wool socks, but that's only in the wintertime and in New Jersey. Most of the time I wear cotton, though. laugh. So, okay. First of all, this word, everybody calling everybody a wolf because they don't agree with what everybody else says. You can't have a differing opinion without being called a wolf. I could easily call them a wolf. As a matter of fact, I could point out as to the reason why the people who are calling me and Sin City Preacher wolves are actually wolves themselves. It's all a matter of semantics, my friends, semantics. And what they're trying to do is trying to keep you from watching my videos, trying to suppress you watching my videos, okay? I don't really care if you watch this person's. Go ahead and watch everybody's videos. Watch the wolf's videos. Watch the sheep's videos, whatever you want to call it. Watch the people who have the true truths videos. Watch all the videos you want to watch and go to all the channels you want to watch and compare what I say to what they say. Then if you agree with what I say, great. And if you want to go on to what they say, great. But don't start calling me a wolf. And I won't start calling everybody, I'll call you a wolf, and we'll all play Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf. It's a ridiculous accusation. Because I'll tell you what, although people might disagree with me on my doctrine, what I teach, sets people free. Bottom line, what does it tell you to do? Trust in the Lord Jesus Christ and not your own self and not your own ability to keep yourself from sin. Whereas these other people will tell you, oh, no, you need to repent. And by repentance, you need to make yourself holy before God because can't, God, without holiness, you won't see God. So you've got to be holy. Okay? So let me explain this to you very, very clearly. Okay, anybody that tells you that you stand in anything but Jesus Christ's holiness, when you stand in your own holiness, you've now trampled the blood of Christ under your feet. So these people who are telling you to trample the blood of Christ under their feet and say that, well, your own personal holiness gets you to heaven is ridiculous. The only holiness that we need is the holiness of Christ. Without that holiness, we're not going anywhere. Okay? So, yes, without the holiness of Christ, we will not see God. Okay? Yes, should we try to be holy? Yes. We are a set apart people. Okay? But we are not perfect. Nobody can get to heaven by their personal righteousness. So if somebody says to you that you need some degree of holiness to get to heaven, they're the wolf. I can tell you that for sure. Now, these people will tell you, well, these people are telling you to sin. So the major accusation against me is I'm telling you it's okay, you can sin all you want. Okay? Well, let me just put this in perspective for you. Okay? First of all, I have never said to sin purposely. I go along the lines of what Paul said, that you should live a holy life to the best of your ability. But the thing that I'm telling you is you should not get down on yourself because of your inability to be holy. You should not get down on yourself for that. Because Jesus Christ paid for your sins and you can rejoice in the love that he has for you. Does that mean I'm telling you to sin all you want? No, I'm telling you not to use your freedom from the law as a license to sin. Now this actually accusations have been thrown at me and Sin City Preacher long enough. We have never preached, nor do we ever preach, that you can just go ahead and if you want to live a life of sin, okay? We've never, ever told anybody to go and sin. No, okay? That is not what we preach. we preach that now that you've been freed by the blood of Jesus Christ, okay, now that you've been freed by that, if you sin, you have an advocate with the Father. If you sin, Jesus Christ covered you for your sins. These people will tell you, but if you don't try to sanctify yourself, Jesus will no longer love you. Jesus' blood doesn't cover you when you sin. Okay? And the problem with that is that then you're basically taking the blood of Christ away. The very thing that you need to live, the very air that you breathe, grace, and the love of Christ that covered you even though you sinned, they're taking away by telling you that you're not good enough or not worthy to have your sins taken away. When, by the way, that was the reason why the blood came, because you're not worthy. You'll never be worthy to have your sins taken away. You weren't worthy of that to begin with. That's what gives glory to Jesus Christ. He took your sins away, although you were sinners. Jesus Christ died for you. So is that message, that Jesus loves you and died for your sins, a wolf's message? Am I telling you to go sin that grace abound? No. I'm telling you to trust in Jesus and in the blood of Jesus. This is why it says in Galatians, who has bewitched you? Who told you to go back to try to sanctify your flesh to try to be pleasing to God? You started off by grace, and you're being sanctified by grace. The more you look on the Lord Jesus Christ, the less you sin. But the more you look on your own sinful nature, the more you'll sin more. So now that you've been saved by grace, you're trying to perfect yourself by the flesh. You went back to the law again. Now, these people will tell you that you're back under the law and you need to self-sanctify yourself. And because I'm telling you to not to do that, to not regard your sins, but look on your Savior and trust in His blood and then live by the Holy Spirit, which actually makes the love of Christ come out of you. And that Holy Spirit tells you that you don't have any more, their sin was taken away. And what does that do? That frees your heart up. It frees you to be able to worship Him. Because your sins were taken away completely, you know that you can never be snatched out of His hands. You know His love. Your heart changes, and when it changes, the smile comes across your face, and you sing hallelujah because your sins were taken away. Where these people will take the smile off, wipe the smile straight off your face, and tell you that you're still under some sort of law, and that God doesn't love you, and the Holy Spirit can't dwell with you if you have sin in you. When Jesus' blood took away that curtain between your sin and the law and the Holy Spirit and now can dwell with you through the blood of Jesus Christ, they're taking the blood of Christ away. So those people who are taking the blood of Christ away are anti-Christ, telling you that we're wolves. Where I'm telling you that the blood applies, if I'm telling you that the blood of Jesus applies, I am not a wolf. I am of the good shepherd. This shepherd is of the wolf. Me and Sin City Preacher are telling you the truth, that you can trust in the blood of Jesus Christ and you can rest in it. And no, you're not supposed to sin. We never told you that you should sin, but that even if you do sin, you still have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ. Even if you do sin, Jesus still loves you. These people are telling you that if you sin, Jesus won't love you anymore. Now you tell me, what message is the truth? If you think of it the other way, that's fine. Go your way. Call me a wolf all you want. I don't really have any problems with you. But if you think that my message is of a wolf and I'm telling you of the blood of Jesus Christ that sets you free, come on. Okay? If you really know, oh, well, you're preaching that the Bible isn't inerrant and you're preaching this, that, the other thing. Look, what I'm preaching to you is the blood of Jesus Christ. What I believe about inerrancy of Scripture and all that kind of stuff, I see a certain way, sure. Okay. And if you see it, that's fine and good. But I have never and should never, and neither should Sin City Preacher be called a wolf by somebody. Because we're telling you about the love of Jesus Christ. God bless.